فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is lecture number 56 and the final one in the fourth semester, the second article of faith. So with this we have finished two articles, alhamdulillah, the belief in Allah, done. And this is the second article, we are to finish it today inshallah. The belief in the angels and the world of the jinn and devils. And today's lecture number 15 actually from that, so we managed to cover this in 15 lectures, 15 hours almost, alhamdulillah. And this is lecture number 9, dealing with the world of the devils. Subhanallah, we covered the world of the angels in 6 lectures. But we had to talk about the devils in 9 lectures. That shows you that the knowledge of that is important.
We are more discrepancies when we are discussing the jinn. Do you think because of their
interference with what?
We have cancellation of lectures which we did not have before.
Okay. So you want to tell me that the jinn caused the rain and the snow?
That's what I'm saying.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. It looks like that all the previous lectures we spoke about who is Satan, who are the jinn, who are the devils, and the fact that they do have a plan for us to misguide us, to mislead us, and they do have aims. The ultimate goal, you staying with Satan for eternity in hell, and he would accept lesser than that. We spoke about these 6 aims. And we also addressed the means which Satan uses to misguide us. We discussed this last lecture. Today, inshallah, without any further delay, we would like to address and talk about the weapons which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to you with the messengers in the revealed books to combat Satan and the devils. Make sense? How can you win that battle? You must use the weapons which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down for you. These weapons are 9. Of course, we can come up with more, but we came up with 9, summing them up quickly. Let me name them. So hopefully that would create suspense and also interest for you to follow the rest of the lecture, inshallah. Number 1, knowledge. Knowledge is a key in this battle. Because knowledge will help you to be watchful, will help you to be careful once you deal with shaitan. The second weapon which we have, and I'm only naming them because the purpose of the lecture is to actually talk about each one of those, inshallah, is turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking His protection. Al-iltija'u ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal-ihtima'i bih. And this is really the ultimate weapon which we do have. We just started with knowledge because knowledge somehow sheds light on that weapon. صحيح؟ It explains it to you. Number three, weapon number three, adhering strictly to the Quran and the Sunnah. I'm telling you, a lot of the people go astray because they compromise the Quran and the Sunnah. Even the little bit. And again, I shared this with you before. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, رضي الله عنه, في الأثر اللي رواه الإمام الدارمي. He saw those people sitting in circles in a masjid in Al-Kufa. And there is one of them sitting in the middle having pebbles in front of him, pebbles, hasa, huh? Stones. For that person would say, سبحوا ماء. Say Subhanallah 100 times. Then he would take the pebble from that place to that place. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. That's the whole thing started. Huh? And sometimes Subhanallah depends on your madhab. What are you doing? نحن نسبح ونكبر. Never the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم told us to do tasbih like this. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم garments, clothes still there, his utensil where he used to eat still there, and you guys doing this? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud swears by Allah, I have seen those people fighting Ali ibn Abi Talib in Nahrawan, مع الخوارج. They were fighting in the army of Al-Khawarij against Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu in the battle called the Nahrawan. Imagine. Stick to the Sunnah. Stick to the Sunnah. Shaytan can come to you from that door. Number four, adhering to the Jama'ah of the Muslims. Very important. Hadith Abi Darda. في سنن أبي داود قال صلى الله عليه وسلم at the end of the hadith إنما يأكل الذئب من الغنم القاصية. The wolf will only eat the sheep that what astrays from the flock. Stay with the jama'a, jama'at المسلمين. Find jama'at المسلمين. But remember we said adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah, so you must find the jama'a that does what? The sequence is important here. Not just any jama'ah. You must follow the jama'ah that follows the Quran and the Sunnah. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حثنا على الجماعة. Stay together. Number five. Discovering the snares, the traps, and the plots of shaitan. And that takes knowledge too. And we studied that. The means that shaitan uses. That he doesn't come to you straight. He beautifies the matter for you. He works with you gradually. So you got to be aware of the tricks of shaitan. That's why, ya ikhwa, the statement which Ibn Abbas mentioned is a key. عالم واحد أشد على الشيطان من ألف عابد. عالم واحد, one scholar, is harder. Shaitan would have a hard time with that scholar than 1,000 worshipper. Why? Because the knowledgeable person knows what? He knows this is shaitan business here. That's why with the ulama, with the scholars, shaitan normally does not stop at his effort. He normally mobilizes the human shayateen to help him in the battle with the scholars. Seriously, يستعين بشياطين الإنس. They normally come after him. Tatra in delegations, one after another. Fitna. هكذا. Number?
Six.
Opposing the shaitan. Shaitan loves hastiness. Is that correct? Hastiness? Can you say that? Shaitan loves hastiness. Then you should be what? Take your time. الشيطان wants you to eat with your, so he can eat. You should eat with what?
Right.
Right. and on, opposing the shaitan. The shaitan wants you before you sleep, commit a sin, and forget to recite Ayatul Kursi. So he overnights in bed with you. So opposing the shaitan, make sure. When you enter the house, he's waiting for you to forget saying, so he can enter with you. It's a battle, akhi, it's a game, wallah. ولذلك الحسن البصري, he was asked, أينام الشيطان, أينام إبليس, does إبليس go to sleep? قال لو نام لاسترحنا. If he goes to sleep, then we'll get a break. Satan doesn't sleep. He doesn't sleep. It's a battle, it's a war. You have to know how to oppose shaitan. Number?
Seven.
That comes, shaitan, like I mentioned, and for you to understand, number seven, shaitan, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كما في صحيح مسلم, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ آيَسَ أَنْ يُعْبَدْ. Once it comes to us, Muslims. Shaitan giving up the fact that he will be worshipped. But he is contented with bringing animosity amongst us, dividing us, hating one another. ولكن رضي, شوف النص, بالتحريش بينكم. He is satisfied with what? Separating you. Now, here is one weapon in order to prevent Satan from doing that. That you must leave no ground whatsoever for suspicion in the heart of your brother. Don't cause your brother to doubt you. وأسوتنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Our example is the Messenger of Allah. He was sitting with his wife Safiya at night in Ramadan. And two Ansari passing by, of course, Safiya was wearing niqab. For those who say niqab is not in the Quran, is not in the Sunnah, she was wearing niqab. The two Ansari did not know, but he's standing with a woman. So they walked quickly. يعني إيه, let the Prophet have إيه. شوف. He called him, come back. This is Safiya. My wife. شايف؟ Look at that. ليه؟ Why؟ لأن مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سوء الظن بالنبي كفر. When you doubt the messenger is flirting, والعياذ بالله, استغفر الله to say this, you have disbelieved. فقالوا يا رسول الله, يعني why are you telling us this, يا messenger؟ قال إني أخاف أن يقذف الشيطان في قلوبكما شيئا فتكفر, واللفظ الآخر فتهلك. I'm afraid Shaitan will cast into your heart some thoughts, evil thoughts about me, then you disbelieve, then you're ruined. وبعدين ذكر الحديث, إن الشيطان يجري من ابن آدم مجرى الدم في العروق. Shaitan circulates in the blood, in the system, in the veins of the son of Adam, like blood circulates. Something, ikhwa, yani I'm focusing on this because it's important for us to come together, to be together. Togetherness. Without togetherness, you see, last night was so beautiful. It's not about the money, it's not about how much we raised. It's about the togetherness that we saw last night. Was so beautiful. Was so beautiful. Togetherness. Shaitan hates that. Shaitan hates that. Huh? Shuf. Now, you could say something that your brother could understand it a different way than your intention, than what you intended. Look what Allah is telling you. وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ. Tell my servants, I'm not translating literally, I'm just trying to get you to get the essence of the verse. Tell my servants to choose their words carefully when they speak to one another. Because Shaitan can make your brother take the word out of context. Be careful. A weapon to fight shaitan with, in order not to end up with a lot of animosity, that you choose your words carefully when you speak. Number? You're right, Fasih al-Din. You're right.
Thank you.
All right. Repentance and seeking forgiveness. Killer. Shaitan keeps working on you, keeps working on you, get you in trouble, and then you tell, Allahumma ghfir li ya Rab. Ya Rab, ani ghaltan, ya Rab. I'm sorry, ya Allah. I made a mistake. Ighfir li ya Rab. Khalas. Man, and over and over. ولذلك in the day of Arafah, what does he do, Shaitan? You don't know what he does in the day of Arafah? He put sand on his head in the place of Arafah. Why? 4 or 5 million people, that's my work. I've been working for all these years. Go back like a newborn. Ya Allah, this is... Tawbah, istighfar. The last one, the fortress. Dhikrullah. The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shuf ya ikhwa. Utlu ma uhiya ilayka min al-kitab. Shuf, knowledge. That's why we're going to start with knowledge. The first weapon is knowledge. Utlu ma uhiya ilayka min al-kitab. Recite that which was revealed to you from the book. Wa aqim as-salah. And establish the salah. Why? Inna as-salata. Some of you may say, Ya Sheikh, I've been praying and I'm still doing fahsha and munkar. It says what? Establish the salah. You're not establishing the salah. You're praying. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. You're not praying. Aqim. The way that the Prophet prayed. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The salah is going to help you stop evil. But the way that you're praying, if you're praying and you're still doing it, that means there is something wrong with your salah. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Look at this now. Shall I tell you something that really can do it? وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. The remembrance of Allah is what? That can help you a lot. Protection from shaitan. وَذَكِنْ تَلِي. شوف فقه البخاري يا إخوة. فقه الإمام البخاري للسنة. You know, he started with the book of الوحي. The book of revelation. Huh? Then the book of knowledge. Then the book of salah. Then the book of zakah. And then he ended with التوحيد. You know the last hadith الإمام البخاري compiled in his sahih is what hadith? Anybody knows? كلمتان خفيفتان. لا خفيفتان الأول. ثقيلتان هنا. خليك معايا يا ريس. أنا منهم. كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان. حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. ثقيلتان في الميزان. سبحان الله وبحمده. سبحان الله العظيم. شوف هذا. فقه. عايز يقول لك إيه. In spite of all of the above, one thing that can help you. Dhikrullah. But when we say dhikrullah now, we have to define what dhikrullah, okay? Because there are dhikrullah out there, huh? No, that's not what we're talking about. And we're going to come to it, inshallah. Are you ready?
Yeah.
That's it. That's all introduction. Huh? Knowledge. The more you know, let me put it this way, about the enemy and his aims and means in which he misleads you, the more you can save yourself from him. The knowledge. Ya ikhwa, the area where shaitan, Satan, is fighting you is your heart. Shaitan wants your heart. He wants to occupy your heart. He's after that limb. He doesn't want your hand. He doesn't want your feet. Because if he gets the heart, he can command what? The hand and the feet. The heart is the, what do you call it? The central control or?
CPU,
the center processing unit. CPU. Intel Insight. What about that? Islam Insight. Ibn al-Jawzi, wallahi, I have never seen a description like this in my life. But I hope you live with your imagination now. I want you to give me 2 minutes. Don't think about your car. Your car is good. Inshallah, you're going to be okay tonight. Work is going to be fine. Allah will take care of you. But give me 2 minutes to see how Ibn al-Jawzi very brilliantly, eloquently depicted that fight, that war between us and Shaitan. You trying to protect your heart, and he's trying to occupy your heart. Are you ready? 2 minutes, counting down. وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْقَلْبَكَ الْحِصْنِي. هذا كلام ابن الجوزي. Learn that your heart is like a fortress. Fortress. I am speaking English here. وَعَلَى ذَلِكَ الْحِصْنِ سُورٌ. And this fortress is surrounded by a wall. You know what is the wall? Where is the heart? Where is the wall? The chest. الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي قُلُوبِ النَّاسِ لَا فِي صُدُورِ. Shaitan starts the fight from where? The chest. He doesn't go right. The heart is protected. Allah giving you a protected heart. The heart around it, there is a wall. He cannot cross that wall without you allowing him. So there is a wall around what? Your heart. We're doing far, good so far? But there is a problem with that wall. There are gates in it and breaches. Thulam. يعني you may find in that wall a weak brick that Shaitan can knock and enter. Or maybe your gatekeeper is not watching the gate. You know, like sometimes you see these guards holding the weapon and going to sleep. And he sneaks in. So you could sneak in from that wall. From where? Two areas. Where? Help me here. We, gates and breaches. Look at this now. وَسَاكِنُهُ الْعَقْلِ. And your intellect, your reasoning, occupy that fortress. So your brain is where? Ya ikhwa, we believe as Muslims that our brain is in our heart. It's not here. There is a communication here. Let me put it this way. The spiritual brain is here. The reasoning. That this is good, this is bad. And angels have free access to that fortress. Angels do not need a permission. Anytime they go in and out. So this is what? Where is the shaitan from this? Next to the wall, وَإِلَى جَانِبِ السُّورِ رَبَضٌ. A little building where your desires live. Whatever you desire is there. Unlike the angels have a free access to the fortress, the devils have a free access to that building next to the wall. Your desires, they are always there. So you see, where is the... Now, وَالْحَرْبُ قَائِمَةٌ. And there is a war between those who inhabit that little place next to the wall and those who inhabit the angels, the fortress. The moment that you let your guards down, he gets in. But the moment that you wake up and say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, runs out. The problem now, if he goes there and stays for a while, that is the big problem. When shaitan gets into the heart and captures the heart. وذاك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اجسامهم, in some of the hadith, don't you read, their bodies is like the bodies of the human and their hearts are like the hearts of what? وقلوبهم قلوب الشياطين. That a human being would have the heart of what? Shaitan. Because shaitan got there. This guy, he wakes up in the morning, evil. أصبح, he became what? A human shaitan. Shaitan got in that zone there. 2 minutes are over. Made sense? Yeah? Huh? Say? Gates? Women, money, all tied. The area, listen, the battleground is your nafs. Remember when we spoke about the means of shaitan, we said shaitan enters to you from what? From your hawa, what you like. That's why he's living in what? Some people are into women. Come, let's go to the club tonight, grab some. Some people are into money. Wells Fargo don't have a big security. You know, let's try tomorrow. That's shaitan work, not me. I'm not saying that. Huh? See that the imam is encouraging the people to go to Wells Fargo. طيب. فيا إخوة العلم, والله العلم, knowledge is the key. ولذلك وفي الجهل قبل الموت موت لأهله. Ignorance is death before death. Why? When you don't learn about Allah, about your deen, when you don't learn about these things, your heart dies. Now shaitan wants you to be ignorant. And he whispers to you so many ways. For example, come on, you're a prestigious man in the community, you're a big man. You sit to this guy, don't sit, you're going to sit in front of him? You know, I was talking about Ibn al-Jawzi. Huh? You know who used to sit in front of Ibn al-Jawzi? The Khalifa. Khalifa al-Muslimin. He used to sit in his circle. عشان تعلم. One of the Khulafa, one of the Amirs, Amir al-Mu'mineen, sent, I think, to Malik or one of the noble. Come and teach me. He said, لا, 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 لا. You come to me. العلم يؤتى إلي. You come to me, I don't come to you. You know what this Khalifa did? He hired a couple of people to teach his children the knowledge of the deen, so we do not need these guys. So he hired people to teach his children. Khulafa used to have kids. Their kids taught by the best in the, of knowledge. In order what? So that they don't have to go and sit with what? ما يروحش يقعد مع العوام في وسط حلقة العلم. فالشيطان plays games on you. I hope you're not understanding that I'm saying this about myself. Oh, this guy doesn't have the knowledge. You know, like I was talking the other day, you know, he's not approved by this sheikh and that sheikh. Like that. Shaitan plays a game just to distract you, throw away you from knowledge, not to learn. Another thing, well, I'm not acting upon the knowledge. Isn't that? A lot of the people, they say, the problem is I'm afraid to learn and I don't implement it. So what are you going to do, Habibi? I'm not just going to learn. I'm going to stay ignorant. Yes, Allah. هذا تذكرة عجيب. So many ways, shaitan that comes to you. The second weapon quickly is turning to Allah and seeking His protection. And this is the way, brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded His messenger, وَقُلْ ربي أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين. Oh Allah, protect me from the insinuations, the whispers of شيطان. Protect me. وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ, على طول turn to Allah. Whenever شيطان whispers to you, turn to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. There are certain times when you must do this. Number one, when you go into the bathrooms. Hadith Anas, في الصحيحين, I believe, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to enter to relieve himself, he used to say, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبث. Oh Allah, I seek refuge, I seek your protection from the male and female demons, devils. Another wording of this hadith, ya ikhwa, I believe في سنن أبي داود. نعم, حديث زيد بن أرقم رضي الله عنه, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن هذه الحشوش محتضرة. Normally the area where you relieve yourself is inhabited with demons, wherever you are. Now, to protect yourself from these demons, from the devils, you must make the dua. The second time you're supposed to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His protection, when you get angry. Wallahi ya ikhwa, when you get angry, you know how kids play with toys? You know how the kids mess around with toys? Shaitan does the same with you when you get upset. Shaitan does the same. طبعاً الأولى that you shouldn't get angry to begin with. يعني a man came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, huh? And he said to him, يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, give me نصيحة. قال, he said to him what? Two words. لا تغضب. Don't get upset. Don't get angry. يعني another wording of this hadith, tell me about something that can take me to Jannah. To Jannah. قال, لا تغضب. Don't get upset. Don't get angry. فالأولى to begin with, that you shouldn't get upset. But I want to tell you, Shaitan normally comes to you and ignites what? Oh, look at him. He's talking about this. Are you going to leave him? Come on. You're the Imam. And he's talking to you like this? Huh? Come on. Do something about it. لا. لا تغضب. Don't get upset. Even if people give you a hard time, if people give you a hard time, don't get upset. في مسند البزار مر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by like a circle. You know these Van Damme movies? أعوذ بالله, I don't know it. You guys know it. You know where they have a circle and two people in the middle fighting one another, boxing? So he saw that. So Salam passed by a group of people. They're having a circle. Yeah, yeah, let's do it. And everybody's boxing anybody. You know, like, I guess they. He said, what are you guys doing? He said, this man beating down this man. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَفَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ, can I tell you someone who's stronger than this man? Can I tell you about somebody who is stronger than this man? بلى, يس يا رسول الله. قال رجل, someone was insulted by another man, that you insult me. فكظم غيظه, and this person suppressed his anger. كظم, كظم الغيظ. Okay, I'm not going to do anything about it. شوف, والكاظمين غيظ, كظم الغيظ. كظم غيظه, then what? فغلب شيطان. When you suppress your anger, what did you do? You defeated your own شيطان. وغلب شيطان صاحبه. And he defeated the شيطان of his, the man who insulted him. Yeah, ما هو يا إخوة, listen. يعني, I want to tell you. Look what الشافعي said. Listen carefully. إذا نطق السفيه فلا تجبه. When the foolish insults you, don't answer him. فخير من إجابته السكوت. It's far better for you not to answer him, just to be silent. فإنك إن كلمته فرجت عنه. Actually, when you answer him, you relieve him. He says, I got him. It's working. Let me be insulting. Be insult him more. وَإِنْ خَلَّيْتَهُ كَمَدًا يَمُوتُ. And if you leave him and ignore him, he will die out of anger. Deaf ear. This guy has a deaf ear. He doesn't hear. سَكَتْتُ عَنِ السَّفِيهِ فَظَنَّ أَنِّي. I'm not responding to the foolish, the one who's insulting me. And he thought that عَيِّتُ عَنِ الْجَوَابِ وَمَا عَيِّتُ. He thought that I'm unable to answer. ده كلام الشافعي يا إخوة, الإمام الشافعي. إذا نطق السفيه فلا تجبه فخير من إجابته السكوت فإن كلمته فرجت عنه وإن خليته كمدا يموت سكت عن السفيه فظن أني عييت عن الجواب وما عييت. By Allah, Mr. Foolish, I'm able to be as nasty as you are. But I'm not going to do it because I have a standard. And I'm telling you, it kills. Wallahi, it kills. When somebody insults you, Allah forgive you, brother. It's okay, sir. Assalamu alaikum. Kills. But that takes what? ليس الشديد بالسرعة. Memorize this hadith. The strong person is not the one who yells loud and says, if that and am that. لا. ولكن الشديد. Huh. The strong one is من يملك نفسه عند الغضب. Is the one who controls himself when he gets angry. وده بيظهر محاسنك. That shows the goodness in your character. يعني I love هذا القصيدة للشافعي. يقول إيه؟ يخاطبني السفيه بكل قبح. The foolish is insulting me in a very excessive way. فأكره أن أكون له مجيبا. But I hate to respond to him. يزيد سفاهة فأزيد حلما. He increases in his foolishness, in his insult to me. And I increase in my forbearance. شوف شوف التشبيه. كالعود زاده الإحراق طيبة. You know العود? What's it called? لا اللي هو البخور. The incense. Incense when you burn it. The more fire you put underneath it, the more what? So the fire is the foolish. It's burning you. But because of your attitude and reaction, more smell is coming. Ya salam. That's how it's done. How it's done. غضب, anger. Ya ikhwa, a key. La taghdar. وذلك هذا الصحابي, this companion, give me نصيحة, give me advice that takes me to Jannah. He tells me two words. He said, by Allah, I reflected upon the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I found out that anger is the fountain of all evil. The worst decision that you can make in your life when you're angry. And a lot of you tell your wife talaq when you're angry. Sahih? The worst decision. Brothers come to me, I got me angry. Got you angry? I have never heard somebody who goes to his wife. I divorce you, my wife. Nobody does this. She must get you angry. But you're supposed to do what? That's strength. Brother, I divorce. طيب. So we said ideally that you should not what? Get angry. But now, what happens if you get angry? We're weak. We all get angry. I get angry. You get angry. We're weak. We're human. What should you do when you get angry? Number one. So what should you do when you get angry? الاستعاذة بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. That you seek refuge with Allah from Shaitan. That's one. Immediately, when you get angry, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. But again, brothers, a lot of you may say, يا أخي, every time I say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, and I'm still, nothing changes. Yeah, because you say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لا يا حبيبي. شوف يقول لك إيه؟ يقول لك أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم is like a sword in your hand. With the sword you can do this. صحيح؟ أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم because you're liking. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Say it like you mean it, man. Come on, man. If you want to leave that, gotta mean it. Gotta come out from a heart. ما ينفع نترك. فالاستعاذة بالله like you mean it. Like you really want to come out of it. But don't say it while you know, you're sitting in a gathering and it's really haram is going on. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. How long are we guys staying here? Huh? ما تنفع هذا. والله. If you say 1,000 أعوذ بالله من الشيطان, we'll never help you. Will never help you, I'm telling you. That's the way it is. Number two. Don't speak. Time is running out. I gotta share with you this hadith. Hadith Sulaiman ibn Surad. في البخاري ومسلم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting in a gathering like this. And he saw two companions from a distance fighting. Cursing one another. One of them, his face turned red from insulting the other one. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ كَلِمَةً لَوْ قَالَهَا لَذَهَبَ عَنْهُ مَا يَجِدْ. By Allah, I know a statement, a word, a sentence. If he says it, all what he is experiencing will depart. I'll leave him. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. One man went and told him that. You see something very interesting about this hadith that Rasulullah ﷺ did not go and tell him. He did not command anybody to go and tell him. But this man voluntarily, a companion voluntarily went and said, say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. You know what the man said? Why, you think I'm crazy? You think I'm crazy? That tells you that when somebody's angry, don't speak to them. Even that. When somebody's angry, don't speak to them. The best way to handle angry people is what? Don't respond. You are this and you are that. I said, okay. All right. One of the women in Egypt tells her husband, طب لو كنت راجل طلقني. If you're a man, divorce me. She's angry. She's angry. And then the husband says, خلاص انت طالق. لا خيبة. You know, he says, okay, I divorce you. She's angry. Don't talk to her. Well, that is true. Sir. The man came to the sheikh and said, sheikh, my wife telling me, if you're a man, divorce me. She tells him that. So he decided to divorce her. Wait. So this is number one. Number two, stop, do not talk. الحديث يا إخوة, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو لا. When you're angry, no خير, no goodness will come out of your mouth. طيب number three, remember the reward for suppressing anger. It's tremendous, إخوة. Enough that it will lead you to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. شوف هذا. Look at these three levels. والكاظمين الغيظ. Two. والعافين عن الناس. This will give you the level of ihsan, the highest rank in that religion, and that will give you the love of Allah. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Started with what? Suppressing your anger. I'm telling you, brothers, wallahi, this is out of personal experience. I used to get angry. I used to be very hot-blooded. Right now, alhamdulillah, wallahi, yani, you hardly, yani, alhamdulillah. Min Allah hadha. But something that really helped me a lot, I'm telling you, this is out of personal experience, that I saw how people behave when they get angry. Man, I act like this? This is disgusting. You know, when you have you ever seen people getting angry, how they become? Man, I'm going to be like this when I get angry? Astaghfirullah. Doesn't even look the best way, wallahi. It helps you stay away from anger. So seeking refuge with Allah when what? When you get angry. Number four, you change your position. So we said number one is what? Seeking refuge. Number two? Huh? Do not speak. Number three? Remember the reward. Number four? Remember how people look like when they get angry. Number five? Change your position. في مسند أحمد the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says إذا غضب أحدكم وهو قائم فليجلس. If you're standing while you're angry, sit down. And if you're sitting down, recline or stand up. Just change your position. Why? That tells you also that shaitan what? Possesses you. Now if you keep the same position, shaitan is going to be still in control of the center process. But if you move around, huh? You may be able to collect yourself. Okay, we said seeking refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when? When you enter into the bathroom. Number two, seeking refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the protection of Allah when you get angry. Number three, seeking protection with Allah when you have intercourse with your wives. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we're having a lot of shayateen being born into this world. Because Muslims have intercourse with their spouses without seeking refuge with Allah. إنك إن تذرهم يضل عبادك ولا يلد إلا شوف العيال كان على زمان سيدنا نوح at the time سيدنا نوح that children would come out of the womb of the mother what فاجر كفار. Why النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told us كما في حديث ابن عباس في الصحيحين if one of you would come and have intercourse with his wife, if he would say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, if Allah decrees that a baby is born from that intercourse, shaitan will not harm that person. Seeking, number four, seeking refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you stop by a rest area, driving on the highway, and you stop by resting, because you don't know what's happening in that area. That area could be inhabited with shayateen, with demons, with devils. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في سنن ابن ماجه بإسناد صحيح حديث خولة بنت حكيم رضي الله عنها the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says لو أن أحدكم نزل منزلا if any time that you stop at a place you don't know what is happening in that place قال and you would say أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق. What tells you that there is no snake in that area? There is no scorpion in that area. All of this. So if you go into some place that you don't know what is going to happen, you should make the dua. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق. I seek refuge with the most perfect words of Allah from the evil which he created. لم يضره في ذلك المنزل شيء حتى يرتحل. Nothing will befall, harm that person until he leaves. Number 5. فإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. You should turn to the protection of Allah. Seek the protection of Allah when you recite the Quran. Why? Because shaitan is gonna come between you and understanding the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 6. Yeah. Okay. Number 6. Something that you should do. Wallahi haram. By Allah, haram that you don't do this with your children. Ibn Abbas says, al-hadith fi al-Bukhari, كَانَ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to يُعَوِّذُ الْحَسَنَ وَالْحُسَيْنِ He would hold al-Hasan wal-Husayn, his grandchildren, and he would say, أُعِيدُكُمَا بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. I request, I ask the protection of Allah by the virtue of His most perfect names on you to protect you from every demon, every evil. شيطان وهام. الهوام is any animal that may harm you. ومن كل عين لامة and every envious eye. And you know, he used to say, كان أبوكما إبراهيم. Your father Ibrahim. He means what? The grandfather Ibrahim. يعوذ بهما إسماعيل وإسحاق. He used to do the same with his two sons, إسماعيل and إسحاق. مهم يا إخوة that you hold your children at least once every week. أعيذكما بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة. Here is the important piece. ومن كل عين لامة. يا إخوة, something about the envious eye. It will take place. It will happen. When كل عين, look, عين لامة, لا بد أن يلم بك هذا الرجل. يعني whatever the person looked at you must be fall upon you. I think you're not getting it, but let me explain this again. Once it comes to sorcery, سحر, or being possessed by jinn, you could cure it and it could leave without harming you. But something about envious eye, خلاص. ذك العين حق. وذك you must protect yourself before what? مهم. I told you the story of the, والله والله يا إخوة, there is some of you may not know, so I'll say it again quickly. والله يا إخوة, there is a family in my village. No one, everybody know them. The father passed away, and he actually, the two children, the two sons inherited this from him. Just the look, they look at you. If you're not protected, والله. With that, every time I see one of them, actually, he comes and shakes at, هايدو, قل والله أحد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, قل أعوذ برب الفلاق وشر ما خلق. And he knows I'm reading it. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق من شر غاسق إذا وقب. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس. How you doing? Good to see you. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق من شر غاسق إذا وقب. شر النفاثر. I come from a very, الحمد لله, يعني poor family, farmers. My father's wish was to have jamusa. Jamusa is that, like, they call it a cattle, I think. Huh? Cattle? لا, مش بقرة, جاموسة. The black one that gives milk. like the buffalo. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me and I started having some money, so I went home and I bought my father Jamusa. Oh, my father was so excited, man. Wallahi al-azim, I used to see my father talking to that cattle. Wallahi, he used to talk to her. And the cattle used to talk back to him. Oh, oh, oh. And they talking to one another. A very special relationship with one another. I never seen like the dogs here and the people with the dog. Exactly. He's so excited about it. So I was going back home, one of these trips, and I decided to rent a car, have some money, alhamdulillah. Prestige ba ragl fi America, man, fashion. The transportation normally in my village is donkey unlimited. I used to go to school in a donkey, Allah al-Azim. I used to go to middle school in a donkey, riding the donkey to the middle school. Subhanallah, I'm arriving at the border of my village and I'm going home and I'm driving my car. And guess who stops me asking for a ride? قلت يا ليلة سودة ده حيلسح العربية. He's gonna get to the car. I focus on the car. So the moment that he got in the car, قل هو الله, he's sitting next to me. قل هو الله. Allah, I'll never forget it. قل هو الله أحد, الله الصمد, لم يلد ولم يولد. We arrived home. You see, I'm focusing in the car. Subhanallah, قدر الله, the decree of Allah, that my father is entering the house with the jamusa. I saw his eye turning to the jamusa like this. Of course, I was trying to what? To protect what? يا ليلى سودة, he got the jamusa. He got the cat. أقسم بالله العظيم, I swear by Allah, ولست بحانث. At 3 o'clock in the morning, my brothers waking me up. This cattle died in a way, until now, we don't know how it died. We don't know how it died. Was shocked. No complaint, just we found it in the ground. You know, the challenging piece was what? You know, alhamdulillah, I could buy my father another jamusa, but that challenging piece is telling my father is asleep, that the cattle is dead. So I knocked on the door. Assalamu alaikum, Abba. Hey, al-akhbar. What would you say if Allah would give you something and takes it away from you? يعني إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. At the end, subhanallah, my father like استسلم لقدر الله سبحانه. I tell you why I'm telling you الحسد. وذاك عليك بالرقية دائما. الحسد, if somebody looks at you, you're gonna get it. Different to sorcery, different to magic, different to the mess. You could protect yourself from it. Talking about donkeys, also you should seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you hear the braying of a donkey. All right? We finished two. Are we going to hang around or what? We got to finish that because next Wednesday, inshallah, I'm going to Wyoming to speak in the university and we're not going to have a lecture. So this is the final one, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. So number three, adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah is the greatest means to protect oneself from the steps of Satan. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Follow the Quran and the Sunnah, actions. Don't play around. شوف يا إخوة, هذه الآية عجيبة. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ. Oh, you who believe, enter into silm. You know what silm means? Islam. All of Islam. Kaffa. Kaffa. Aqidah. Sharia. Ibadah. Amal. I'tiqad. Everything about Islam. Enter into it. Kaffa. The verse is not over. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا Don't follow the steps of shaitan. The moment that you compromise the commands, the deen, Islam, the moment that shaitan is going to get to you. But if you stick to Islam, to the curriculum, shaitan will have nothing to do with you. Look, يعني, give you an example of something that we take light. And sometimes I feel awkward, even so I shouldn't as an imam, to stress it. But look at this. Look at the hadith. Hadith في مستدرك الحاكم ومسند أحمد. أقيموا صفوفكم. Straighten your rows in the salah. Straighten it. Making it straight. ولا تتخللكم الشياطين. Because if you don't, if you leave gaps between you, shayateen are going to occupy these places. كأنها أولاد الحذف. Like the children of الحذف. They said, who are the children of الحذف, يا رسول الله? He said, locusts. اللي هو الجراد. Locusts. Locusts. In the land of Yemen. Imagine if you leave gaps between you and the salah, shaitan is going to be like what? Like a locust between you. Between you and your brother in the salah. وفي حديث آخر عند الطيالسي يقول أقيموا صفوفكم وتراصوا. Straighten your rows and be straight. فوالذي نفسي بيده. By the one in whose hand my soul is. إني لأرى الشياطين بين صفوفكم كأنها غنم عفر. I see the shayateen. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells his sahaba, I see the demons, the devils between you, like dust colored sheep. اللي هي الغنم اللي ايه? Dusty. Look, subhanallah. Look, when you make sajda tilawa, كما عند مسلم, حديث أبي هريرة, إذا قرأ ابن آدم السجدة, when you recite a verse where there is a سجدة, and you prostrate, اعتزله الشيطان. شيطان leaves him. And he says, by Allah, I was commanded to prostrate, I disobeyed Allah, I'm going to stay in hell for eternity. And the son of Adam prostrated right here for a verse in the Quran, and he's going to go to Jannah. سبابة في الصلاة. سبابة اهو حديث في مسند احمد نافع عن ابن عمر يقول لك this is harder on شيطان like an iron fist when you do like this in the salah التحيات لله الصلوات like you're beating شيطان with an iron fist stuff like that we take light number four quickly adhering to the جماعه of the Muslims Look at this hadith, إخوة عند الترمذي. Abdullah ibn Umar says, خطبنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه. عمر بن الخطاب delivered a sermon in a place called الجابية. And he said, أيها الناس, O people, إني قمت فيكم كمقام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فينا. I'm standing right now in front of you like رسول الله. الجابية is doing حج. In the season of Hajj, like Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. فَكَانَ مِمَّا قَالْ Some of what he said, عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ Stick to the jama'ah. Stick to the togetherness. But again, remember, the previous weapon was what? Was what? Adhering to what? Quran and Sunnah, your jama'ah should be what? Adherence to the Quran and Sunnah, not any jama'ah. عليكم بالجماعه. Stay with the jama'ah. Stay with the togetherness. وإياكم والفرقة. And be aware of this unity. فإن الشيطان مع الواحد. Shaitan will take away that person. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم, and I shared the hadith with you before, حديث أبي داود, حديث أبي الدرداء في سنة أبي داود. ما من ثلاثة في قرية. Three in a village, in a town. لا تقام فيهم الصلاة. They do not establish the salah and they do not pray together except shaitan occupied them. Ah. وفي الحديث يا إخوة اللي هو ال 73 sects, one wording which is the saved one or messenger of Allah, there is one wording الجماعة. But again, الجماعة is explained by what? Those who follow what? الصحابة. ما أنا اليوم عليه وأصحابي. Number five, discovering the traps and the snares of shaitan. And if you want to do this, you go back to the lecture before. You know how he enters, how he misleads you. His weapons, beautifying things, demonizing the good, the weapon of I will, tasweef, exaggeration and negligence. Go back to the weapons which he uses in misguiding you. Number six, opposing Satan. We mentioned some of these examples. We mentioned some more. Being extravagant. إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا. So any time that you're extravagant, you're what? You're following Satan. You're doing like Satan. But you shouldn't be what? Extravagant. But at the same time, you should not be what? Stingy. ولذلك شوف الفقه بتاع عمر بن عبد العزيز. عمر بن عبد العزيز, you know what he said? They ask him, كيف نفقتك? How do you spend? قال نفقتي بين معصيتين. شوف الفقه. شوف الفقه يا إخوة. My spending is between two sins. والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. شوف. You cannot be extravagant at the same time. You cannot be what? Turn the light off. Something that we take very light. Yawning. Yawning. You know when you yawn, Shaitan laughs at you. Shaitan is so happy. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, well, hadith, hadith Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, التثاوب من الشيطان. فإذا تثاوب أحدكم فليرد ما استطاع فإن أحدكم إذا قالها الشيطان لفظة ضحك منه الشيطان. You're supposed to do what? اكتم. Use what? Your hand. These are examples of opposing شيطان. Another fascinating example, I came across it, الحديث في مسند أحمد. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was riding and one of the companions was with him. فده donkey or the mule where الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was riding stumbled. Stumbled, you know? عثر. عثر حمار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقال الصحابي, the صحابي said, تعس الشيطان. May Allah make shaitan perish. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تقل تعس الشيطان. Don't say that. فإنك إن قلت تعس الشيطان تعاظم. When you say may shaitan, may Satan perish, shaitan is going to swell. He's going to say, I got him. شوف. His ego is what? يا إخوة, شيطان, the jinn, they have inferiority problems. They are inferior towards us. You need to understand this. This is an area of their weakness. You sense this from the statement. Why didn't you bow down? What did Satan say? I'm better than him. That's inferiority. When somebody speaks like this, you're feeling what? Inferior. When you say, تعس الشيطان, وذاك, it's a problem. الشيطان, الشيطان, الشيطان. الشيطان يا عم الحاج وكل حاجة الشيطان الشيطان الشيطان. The shaitan is taking a break now from his work because the human are becoming more innovative than him. لا تقل تعس الشيطان. Don't say that because his wills. Rather say بسم الله. So when something goes wrong, you should say what? بسم الله. فإنك إن تقل بسم الله تصاغر. He will shrink. شايف؟ Shrink. Number seven, two more quickly, inshallah. Number seven, we'll make you a deal with Isha, inshallah. Number seven, إزالة اللبس. We mentioned, يا إخوة, and I think I explained this quite well at the very beginning. that one of the areas where shaitan is very active and it's very destructive, especially to communities, placing animosity amongst us. I shared the hadith with you, hadith Sahih Muslim. Shaitan, Satan, given up the fact that he will be worshipped. But he is satisfied with what? Tahrish. Making you dislike me, this person said that, he said that, I said that, you said that. ولذلك when you find this in a community, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَجَعُونَ ولذلك, look, the first thing that you should do, never leave a room for your brother to have suspicions about you. And I shared with you hadith, this is Safiya, my wife. This is my wife. I'm not standing with somebody I'm not supposed to stand with. Why? Because I don't want you to think that. You're my brother. I don't want you to think that about me. Ya ikhwa, two narrators of the hadith, one of them al-A'mash. You know al-A'mash? You know what al-A'mash means? You know when you have these yellow things in your face, what do you call that? Yellow dots?
Freckles.
Freckles?
Freckles?
Freckles. When you have a lot of freckles, one of the narrators is called al-A'mash. And the other one is called al-A'war. The one-eyed. That's their title. فَذَي مِتْ وَلَا نَظَرْ إِنْ دَرُوتِ They were going into a town. فَوَنَ of them said, أَعْمَشْ وَأَعْوَرْ A freckled and a one-eyed walking together. The people are going to talk about us. They are going to what? Slander us. Look at them. Freckled and what? They are walking together. So one of them said, let them speak and we'll get their hasanat. Shuf. Shuf. Because when you speak about your brother in his absence, you get what? Wadak al-Hasan al-Basri, somebody used to backbite him in town. He used to send to him what? Some rai of good deeds and tell him, thank you very much for your good deeds. He didn't say thank you very much, okay? He said, Jazakallahu khair for your good deeds. Look at the other one, what he said. Look what he said. لا نفترق ويسلم. شوف. If they walk together, they're going to backbite them. These brothers, your brother, your Muslim brother is going to get your what? You're going to get his hasanat or you're going to receive his sins. So they said, no, let's divide. Let's walk lonely and so that they keep their hasanat. شوف. شوف. Where are you? Where are we from this? Where are we? Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when he was in Tabuk, someone slandered Ka'b ibn Malik. Rasul asked, where is Ka'b ibn Malik? For one of them from Bani Salam said, Qala ya Rasulallah, shagalahu atfah. He's busy with his clothes. Ka'b ibn Malik used to be a king in Jahili. He's probably busy with his muscles and look what Mu'adh, بِئْسَ مَا قُلْتْ What an awful thing you say about my brother. وَاللَّهِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَا عَلِمْنَا عَنْهُ إِلَّا خَيْرًا He must have a reason not to be here, يا رسول الله. شوف, that's a community. Protective. To keep the peace. Because that's the work of shaitan. When you have rumors going around and you're passing on and this one is passing and this one is passing, this one is passing. Destructive. And I told you last night, wallahi, it was not about the $80,000 that we raised. It was about the togetherness. That we seen these masses in that little room out there together. It was so beautiful. I felt it. It was a blessed night for our community. طيب. Number
eight.
You're not keeping up with me now. Number eight, repentance and seeking forgiveness. Repentance and seeking forgiveness. I think I explained that quite well at the beginning, that you always have to seek forgiveness. Number nine and the last is what? Occupying yourself with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I share with you in this regard a couple of hadith. First of all, the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas. You know what he said? الشيطان جاثم على قلب ابن آدم، فإذا ذكر الله الشيطان wants to capture the heart of the son of Adam. When he remembers Allah, when he mentions Allah, his name, he runs away. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس. خناس. You know what خناس means? Runs away. طب look at this hadith. And how many of you, how many of you would do this? الحديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. One more hadith and we're done. Couple of minutes. إن شاء الله. الحديث في مشكاة المصابيح. يعني صحيح في المشكاة. وراه أبو داود والترمذي. إذا خرج الرجل من بيته. When you leave your house in the morning. فقال and you say بسم الله توكلت على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. An angel will say هديت وكفيت ووقيت. بسم الله. You know the meaning of this. بسم الله we know. توكلت على الله we know. ولا حول ولا. An angel will say you're guided, this is one, you're protected, you're taken care of. Then a jinni, a devil, will say to the other devil, how come you're not following him, how come you're not going after him. فيقول كيف بي برجل قد هدي وكفي ووقي. What do you think I'm going to do with a man who is guided, protected, taken care of? How many of you need to start doing this in the morning? Bismillah, tawakkaltu Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Ya ikhwa, I love this hadith. Hadith muttafaq alayh, hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Shuf. Man qala la ilaha illa Allah. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. You memorize this, don't you? You memorize it, don't you? لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت على كل شيء قدير. 100 times. 100 times. Can you do it? What will happen? As if كانت له عدل عشر رقاب. As if you freed 10 necks from slavery. وكتبت له 100 حسنة. 100 حسنة. Righteous deeds. حسنات written in your book. ومحيت عنه 100 سيئة. And 100 sins erased from your book. Here is what we're looking for. وكانت له حرز وكانت له حرزا من الشيطان يومه ذلك حتى يمسي. And this will be his protection from شيطان for the whole day. Talking about protection. This is the one right here. We left the rest for last. With this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we conclude the second article of faith, believing in the worlds of the angels and the devils and jinn. And inshallah, our next semester, semester 5, if we're still alive, inshallah, if we're still alive, we're going to start talking about belief in the books and the messengers. Inshallah, both tests, you're going to get tested, this one, and I'll get you the last test, بإذن الله تعالى. You're asking, when is that? بفضل الله تعالى, I want to share this with you, and I think I should. I'm expecting my first boy.
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.